welcome to day four of Cybos 2021, the final day of this year's event, which has seen us welcome over 18,500 attendees from almost every country in the world. Lots to look forward to today, but first, let's look back at some of the highlights from day three.
One of the big themes of the day was the evolution of risk management in what is a fast-moving and technologically innovative sector, particularly around assets of the future. Here's Sir John Cunliffe, Chair of BIS, CPMI and Deputy Governor of Financial Stability at Bank of England, talking about whether the world of crypto poses a risk to financial stability.
When something in the financial system is growing very fast and growing in largely unregulated space, financial stability authorities have to sit up and take notice. They have to think very carefully about what could happen and whether they or other regulatory authorities need to act. At the same time, we do need to be careful not to overreact, particularly when faced with the unfamiliar. We should not classify new approaches as dangerous simply because they're different. Innovation, technology, and new players can tackle long-standing frictions and inefficiencies and reduce barriers to entry. From a financial stability and from a regulatory perspective, what matters is not the underlying technology, but how it's used and the purpose for which it is used. In other words, we should not regulate technologies, but rather the activities that the technology is performing. And in doing so, we need to ensure a consistent approach to risks, regardless of the technology used.
And the role of the regulator in this fast-changing space was discussed in yesterday's big issue debate on assets of the future.
The regulators also need to, understand what new risks are being introduced, right? With these innovations and whether the existing laws and guidelines for investor protections and, can provide safeguard against these risks. And that requires a big investment of time and a deeper level of understanding of the products, the technology, the actors, and the motivations, and so we can have the proper guardrails as well.
Well, that theme of managing risks also included cyber attacks. The industry is very good at managing cyber risk, but it is a risk that is definitely here to stay.
The banks have already deployed huge protections against cyber attacks. However, the cyber risk will continue to increase in importance in the next years. Due to the growing digitization of the economy, the banking services themselves, the use of new tech, the new ways of working, as well as the increasing amount of data stored in the banks.
And for the final word on cyber risk, let's hear from Bernie Mensah.
One of the risks is definitely cyber. If we have more things online, if more things are digital, then if somebody's able to break through, so a lot of the money that we do spend in some of our core competence is cybersecurity. I'd love one day, I wish people could see it. I'm sure other banks have it, just some of our offices around the world that we have that are just dedicated to keeping us safe.
So, some of the highlights from yesterday there, but what about today? Day four of Cybos 2021.
We will be asking some of the big questions in our two interactive live panel sessions today. What keeps FI and fintech influencers up at night? What are the most important opportunities and challenges they and the industry as a whole face between now and 2025?
Elsewhere, we can meet the winners of the Swift Hackathon, join an Inner Tribe session on the future of work, and discuss how to become an effective change maker.
And rounding off yet another stimulating Cybos will be the closing keynote, which will reflect one of our core themes this year, when we hear from Mark Carney, the UN Special Envoy on Climate Action and Finance.